The sequel of the much-anticipated sci-fi blockbuster Dune set to hit Philippine theaters Wednesday. Gretchen Folido caught up with some of the film stars in Seoul, South Korea, where they talked about the Filipino martial art, Kali, and their desire to explore the Philippines. Take a look.
Nothing fancy.
Hollywood stars Timothy Chalamet and Zendaya are back reprising their roles as Paul Atreides and Shani in the much-awaited sci-fi sequel Dune Part 2. ABS-CBN News had the chance to interview the stars in Seoul, South Korea, and they dished out what fans can expect from their characters and love story.
I think what has been really special, I think, is watching Timothy and Paul come into their own and realize their destiny in many ways. And I think it was really special to watch, I don't know, he was becoming a leading man, you know, in front of our eyes, while also Paul was kind of doing that too and stepping up to, I think, high expectations and I mean, being the center of a movie like this is, you know, no pressure. And I think you handled it beautifully. So I got to see you, I don't know, come into your own.
That might be the nicest thing
she said
ever
before.
To me.
As a response to me, for me, I mean, Zendaya Chani's the heart of this movie. You know, she's sort of the, I think, what an audience can relate to emotionally. At some point, Paul goes off in the wilderness as far as a relatable experience, you know, and Chani's experience is more grounded.
In Dune Part 2, Austin Butler is introduced as the psychopath villain Fade Rautha Harkonnen. Veteran actor Stellan Skarsgård says Butler is perfect for the role.
He's such a good actor, and he's got such a good sense of humor, and he's got such a... He enjoys so much being evil. He out-eviled me.
Skarsgård also shared that it takes 8 hours for his prosthetic makeup transformation for his character Baron Harkonnen and 3 hours in the chair for Butler.
According to Timothy Chalamet, Austin Butler, and director Denis Villeneuve, the Filipino martial art Kali is incorporated in the fight scenes in Dune Part 2.
Yes, there's part of it. I will say that I work with Roger Yuan, that is a martial art specialist. Mm. And that he make the combination of different technique that when try to create a new form of combat, and Kali was definitely one of them.
Well, we had a Kali instructor in Los Angeles named Alvin, who was incredibly talented, knowledgeable, experienced in Kali, and we worked with him separately, I think. And then in Budapest, got together and relearned the fight, which is difficult.
Butler shares that he's been exposed to Kali since he was a kid.
I actually took Kali as a kid.
Oh.
Yes, I had a Filipino trainer when I was a kid. And then,
Yeah.
He was destined.
Yeah.
Destined.
That's right.
And it's such an amazing martial art because you can use any weapons. You can use sticks, you can use knives, you can use your fists, or whatever. And you could use a newspaper rolled up. There's so many variations on it.
Is Dune Part 3 or the script already in the work?
Thank you for your enthusiasm, because the way the people will receive the movie give us energy to move back to the desert, which is not easy to do. And let's say that I'm writing right now. We are writing, and when the screenplay will be ready, then I will go back into shooting, but that might take a while. We'll see.
Given the chance, the cast of Dune Part 2 says they want to visit the Philippines.
I've always wanted to visit, and it would be an absolute dream. I would love to meet. I've only kind of corresponded or seen fans, you know, through social media, but it would be such a pleasure to be able to see them in person and give them some love.
I would love to go to the Philippines. I would love to visit.
I've always wanted to go to the Philippines as well. Enjoy the beaches. The people are the sweetest people in the world.
Dune Part 2 is showing in Philippine cinemas on February 28. Gretchen Fulido, ABS-CBN News.
Filipino actress Liza Soberano joined some of the biggest stars of Hollywood on the red carpet for the 30th Screen Actors Guild, or SAG, Awards. It's a dream come true for Soberano to attend her first major Hollywood awards show. The actress became a member of the Hollywood Actors Union when she worked on Lisa Frankenstein. Soberano says she's still in disbelief at the direction her career has taken.
This is a big deal for me, and this is what I've dreamt of, and so I have to constantly remind myself that, you know, you worked hard to get here, and everything that's happening is magic.
The 30th SAG Awards is now available on Netflix. Gilas Pilipinas successfully sweeps its assignments in Window 1 of the 2025 FIBA Asia Cup qualifiers. The Nationals overwhelmed visiting Chinese Taipei 106-53 Sunday night to move to 2-0 in Group B, sharing the spot with New Zealand. Justin Brownlee led Gilas with 26 points, while Kai Soto had an all-round performance with 18 points, 19 rebounds, 5 assists, and 2 blocks. The next games of Gilas for the FIBA qualifier will be in November. In the meantime, Coach Tim Cohn says the team still has a long way to go before their next scheduled games in July in Europe for the Olympics qualifiers.